Welcome, collectors, to the Teeny Titans Hints and Tips official video. Whether you're just starting out or you're looking for some pro tips to up your game, this one's for you. It's good to chat. Don't ignore that purple speech bubble and just smash battle. Even though some characters will just be annoying and weird, some really know their stuff and can even give you new missions. Stay alert! So, even though the battles may look turn-based, it's a lot more intense than that. It's all about keeping your eye on your power bar and your opponent, and then hitting the right moves at the right time. Believe us, every millisecond counts, so no mid-battle snacks. Share the love. Okay, so this is a big one. In a battle, your power bar is shared by all three of your figures, so you can boost it with one character's move, like Cyborg, and then switch in someone with a move that needs a more full bar to take advantage. Make sense? Some mega powerful moves use a purple power bar, which, if interrupted by an attack from an enemy, is neutralized. So, pro tip, use defensive moves like shields before you attempt a power move, or even better, increase your dodge statistic, but more on that later. Squad up! Definitely worth noting that all figures in your squad, that's six total, gain experience to level up, but the three that you choose for a battle gain the most. Pro tip, keep leveling up a full squad, as this is crucial in the big tournaments at the end of each world. The grind is real, friends. Let's get statistical. Okay, so the stats, basic breakdown. Power, how much damage your guys do. Health, how much damage your guys can take. Dodge, the chance of your guys avoiding attacks. Luck, the chance of getting a lucky duck and doing extra damage. To be honest, on a level up, whenever you can take a power upgrade, you probably should, followed closely by health. The other two can be super helpful, but it's more random. Who wants chips? Once you get a character up to level 5, you can enhance them with mod chips. Don't sleep on the chips. It's easy to forget, but they can really make a difference. You just need to pick the right mod for the right character. For example, if a character takes a while to charge up his best move, like Dr. Light, it makes sense to give them a health chip and buy them those crucial extra few seconds in battle. Be aware! Some mod chips are class-specific and can only be added to certain heroes. What are classes, you say? Funny you should ask. Top class. The class types are six categories which each of the characters fall into. These types are cute, dark arts, super, tech, martial arts, and beast. These classes all have their own style of combat, but the key thing to note is that each class is weak against one class, yet strong against another. It's easy to miss, but this is indicated during a battle by a green thumbs up and a red thumbs down. So look for the green ones and swap in that figure.
Battle ready!
Think of tournaments as the end of level bosses. These are by far the hardest sections of the game, and winning one unlocks the next game area. Each tournament sees you face around 5 opponents in a row. But be aware, damage on your figures is carried over, so things can get pretty intense. Always consider figures with healing abilities, as they can really help you out when your squad has suffered heavy damage. You'll receive 2 random boost boxes during each tournament, but don't rely on these. Lose all 3 heroes in 1 battle and you are out, with all the tournament progress lost. So, think carefully before sending in a figure with low health.
Other stuff.
Okay, that's the main stuff covered, but here's a few bonus tips just because we like you. Whenever you see sparkles on the map, poke those sparkles. You'll get free stuff. Riddler boxes contain random bonuses, but the ones in the shops tend to be more worthwhile, especially early on, and look out for rare gold ones, because guess what? Yep, even more rare stuff inside. Night and day occur just like in real life, just quite a bit quicker. Some stuff is only available at certain times, but you can keep on top of this with your Titan tracker in the bottom right of the screen. And if you're impatient, you can even skip straight to the next phase by snoozing in a hotel. And finally, in Teeny Titans, just remember, losing is no big deal. In fact, you can easily learn from it. Sure, you don't get to watch your favourite figure do a funky dance, but you don't lose anything, so don't be afraid to hit that retry button and restart the same fight. With different strategy comes different results. And that rounds up our Teeny Titans hints and tips. Good luck on your mission to collect all 77 Teeny Titans and defeat the mysterious Hood. Who could he be? Happy collecting!